this week?
Well, I have been intercoming with people with God. That's what I've been doing. The whole week I've been intercoming.
Intercoming? Now, what is intercoming, brother? I've never heard of that before.
Well, I thought you knew the Bible. You've never heard of intercoming?
I've never seen intercoming in the Bible.
Well, you see, this happened when my best friend fell and he hurt his knee very badly. There were blood everywhere. Like, blood here, blood there, blood on his head, blood on his shoes, on his shoes.
Oh, it sounds horrible, brother.
Oh, it was terrible. So he was so much in pain that he couldn't ask God for help. So I intercomed for him before God so that he could be healed. And you see, you can only do that when somebody hurts his knee.
Oh, brother, I think I know what you're talking about.
I know you know.
Yes.
I thought you knew about intercoming.
Yes, it's interceding.
What?
Yes, it means you stand in the gap for somebody. You go between the person and God.
That's a big word. No, it's too difficult.
Okay, but Brilla, you can do it anytime. You don't need to do it only when somebody's knee is hurt.
Are you sure?
Yes. Let's ask Auntie Jill to tell us a bit more about it.
Oh, okay. So today we're going to talk about
interceding.
I mean that word.
Yes, brother.
Okay. Well, let's listen to some worship first.
Okay. Bye, friends.
Bye, guys.
It's so simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah, I don't gotta be afraid no more, no. Cause I know you're up through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a
Our memory verse is Romans 8 verse 34. Christ is at the right hand, so your right hand, of God, and he's interceding for all of us. Say after me, Christ is at the right hand of God, and he's interceding for all of us.
Who of you guys know what interceding is? Yes, it's a big word for just praying. It also means that to stand in the gap, or otherwise to be the go-between. Now what does that mean? Well, say I have a friend. This is my friend Rabbit. And Rabbit really have a big problem. He needs some help. So I go and I take Rabbit's problem and I take it to God and say, God, please go and help him. That is what interceding is. Or just praying for somebody, taking their problems, taking their prayer requests and asking God to help them. Now Peter, he was in big trouble. People took him to jail and they wanted to kill him because he was telling people about Jesus. That must be a big problem if you know your head is going to be on the line tomorrow morning. Well, the church decided they're going to pray for him, they're going to intercede. Let's see what happened.
After Jesus had been taken up into heaven, mean King Herod began doing terrible things to the followers of Jesus. He even had some of them killed. Some Jewish people were happy that Herod was doing this because they didn't believe in Jesus or like his followers. So to please the people, Herod decided to throw Peter in jail too. The king ordered 16 soldiers to guard him over the Passover holiday. But while Peter sat in jail, God's people gathered in their homes to pray for him. That night, an angel came into the jail cell and woke Peter up.
Hurry, get up.
Peter's chains fell off, but the soldiers kept sleeping.
Follow me.
Peter thought he must be dreaming. But he followed the angel right past all the guards. When they came to the iron gate of the prison, it swung open on its own. But after they had walked a few steps into the city, the angel disappeared. So Peter went to the house of some friends who lived nearby and knocked on the door. A servant girl went to the door and asked who was there.
Who is it?
It's Peter. The Lord sent his angel to rescue me from Herod.
The girl recognized Peter's voice and quickly ran to tell the group.
Peter is at the door.
Hello?
But the friends didn't believe the girl and went back to praying for Peter. They didn't realize that their prayers had already been answered. They finally listened to the girl and went to open the door. And that's how God saved Peter from the mean King Herod.
And an angel came to me. He freed me from my chains, and he let me out the door.
God wants us to ask him for what we and others need. This is called intercession. In today's Bible story, we saw how the church made intercession for Peter. Let's see if you guys remember what happened in the story. Who had Peter arrested? How many soldiers were guarding Peter? What did the church do while Peter was in prison? What was Peter doing the night before the trial? Who suddenly appeared? What did the angel do? Ooh, I think I gave you an answer. What happened to Peter's chains? What happened to the prison gate? Where did Peter go when he was delivered from prison? Let's see who of you got any of those right. When the church prayed constantly and earnestly for Peter, God sent his angel to deliver Peter from prison. Another name for an intercessor is a go-between. A go-between or intercessor stands in the gap for someone and takes their needs or requests to God. Did you know that Jesus is the greatest intercessor or go-between? Romans chapter 8 verse 34 says, "Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore is also risen, who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us." This means that Jesus made intercession for us when he died on the cross for our sins, so that we could be made right with God. It also means he is even now at the right hand of the Father, standing in the gap for you and for me as our go-between. Now, we get to be like Jesus and stand in the gap for others. Remember, kids, we are all called to pray and to make intercession, and our prayers can really make a difference. Amazing. Till next week, Supernatural Kids. Bye.
Friends, we now learned that we can intercede for people, we can intercede for situations as well, or for countries. Why not look at televisions or newspapers and see what goes on in countries? Other books you can use is like this one, Strongholds of the 1040 Window, or otherwise I've got this prayer, Kids Prayer Adventures. And inside you can see different countries and what kids are doing in those countries and what you can pray for. One thing one can pray for is the government of a country. So people might pray that the people of the land who rules the land, that they search for God and his will, that they won't be corrupt. We can also pray that there is equal opportunities for kids to go to schools, and that where some countries only boys can go to schools, that girls will be allowed to go to school, and that they will use their education for good and not for bad. We can pray for businesses, that Christians will have businesses and creative ideas, and that they will use some of their profit to increase the kingdom and send missionaries off to different countries and so spread the gospel. We can pray for countries that there will be health systems. Sometimes people stay in areas that's far from hospitals, and that we can pray for supernatural healing in that case. Otherwise, that there will be good doctors who use their abilities for good. We can also pray for safety in the country, that the police and whoever is in charge of security, that they will follow the laws. We can pray for the churches in countries, that they will have unity, where people have to go to underground churches because they're not allowed to have a church, that they will be protected. Also pray for families, that they will stay together, that they will experience safe in surroundings, and that people will love each other, and that they will support each other.
So, look into your newspapers and see what goes on in the world and start praying. Bye-bye.
And that is the end on series of prayer. And guess where is my favorite place to pray? On the trampoline. Next week is the last episode of 2020 Children's Church. Woohoo! Overture is amazing!
Thank you, Rico, for that. Yes, it's amazing. Each one of us have our favorite place to pray. Mine is in my room. I've got this beautiful chair and I look over a small pond just outside my house, and that is my favorite place to pray. So now I'm wondering, where is your favorite place to pray? I would love to know. Why don't you send me a message and let me know where your favorite place is to pray. So today, like Rico said, it's our last episode of the series of prayer. So I want to finish off today's episode by praying for you. Yes, you, because you are important and God loves you. So put your hand on your head. Yes, yes. So I'm only praying for kids to put their hands on their head. Okay, there we go. Father God, I pray for each child who has their hand on their head, and I ask, Lord, that you'll bless them and keep them. Father, I ask for the desires on their heart, that you will make it come to pass. And I ask that you keep them safe over Christmas, wherever they go, Lord, where they are with their family, Lord. Keep them safe in the name of Jesus. Now remember, you are loved by God. He likes you. I like you. I think you are awesome. So guys, next week we do our last episode for Children's Church. It's going to be the episode with 7 Children's Churches. Yes. So don't miss out on that one. And then it's the end of our online Children's Church for 2020. Love you guys. Bye.